right, all right, all right.
For the WBC Heavyweight Championship of the World, introducing in the blue corner, originally from Jacksonville, Illinois, now fighting out of Los Angeles, California, weighing in at 220 pounds, the WBC heavyweight champion, Ken Norton. And in the red corner, the challenger, weighing in at 209 pounds, hailing from Easton, Pennsylvania, the Easton Assassin, Lary Holmes.
Entire worldwide connection is complete, so I'll tell you one more time. This is coming to you live from Caesar's Palace in Las Vegas, Nevada. Don King Productions presents the Heavyweight Championship of the World. Ken Norton, the champion, the challenger, Lary Holmes. The fight of bad blood, again under the direction of the Nevada State Boxing Commission and the WBC, Jose Suleiman, president. We're all set to go. My name is Bob Sheridan. It's been a hot day here in Las Vegas, Nevada, but we're indoors in the sports pavilion here at Caesar's Palace. A lot of championship fights held here. Don King has really done a job putting this one together. Kenny Norton has really had a tough week for him. The week started out, everybody thought that Norton was going to be heavily favored in this fight. The betting odds, as we mentioned, still show it that way. But Lary Holmes, suddenly, there's Lary, a look of confidence, a look of determination. The fight, they call it the fight of bad blood. And if you look in the eyes of that Lary Holmes there, you can see exactly that there's no joking here. It hasn't been the type of buildup that has been commonplace with Muhammad Ali fights. This is a serious situation. We understand that Lary Holmes was working out. Ken Norton walked in, and they got in sort of a shoving match. We're back on Tuesday, and it wasn't the Ali type of hype for the fight. This fight didn't need any hype. In the past, going back to the Thriller in Manila, Joe Frazier and Muhammad Ali, this is probably the best legitimate heavyweight championship fight. Of course, we wouldn't take anything away from the Sphinx Ali fight, but look at the determination in the eyes. Norton looking down, not looking into the face of Holmes. Holmes trying to taunt him. We're all set. It's ready to go. The most pure form of sports, the heavyweight championship of the world. Scoring will be done by three judges. It's the 10-point must system. The three knockdown rule is waived. The bell is sound. Round one, the heavyweight championship of the world at stake. Ken Norton to the right of your screen. Lary Holmes to the left. Norton scores the first blow. The other fellow, Lary Holmes, with a 27-0, 19 knockout record, handled by Richie Giacchetti, has lightning hands. And I mean lightning hands. Back to you is Norton. Now to the left of the screen, to the right of the screen, and the light trunks. Lary Holmes, lightning left hands. He can counter punch while moving away. We're in round one. It's just underway. As you know, the world title at stake. Pretty good pace for round one. We expected the fighters to feel each other out a little bit more, but these guys do not like each other. Lary Holmes has a scowl on his face, and Ken Norton has a look of determination. Both fellas, finely tuned, finely conditioned athletes. Beautiful looking physiques of both of these men. A lightning left catches Norton on the top of the head. No damage done. Lary Holmes is actually a bit taller. Shot at winning the title for Muhammad Ali. Couldn't do it. Very disputed. Very disputed match against Jimmy Young. But right now, he's going to have his hands full with Lary Holmes. WBC ruled that he would be champ, and champ he is. Richie Giacchetti, the man that trains Lary Holmes, told me he'd stay away, try and box away from him, not get tied up in the ropes, wear Norton down, which is a tough row to hoe. Norton has had the experience of going 15 tough rounds with Muhammad Ali on a couple of different occasions. From the camp of Kenny Norton, say he's in the best physical shape ever. Very strong left hand touch. Holmes in the chest. Lary doing what he wants to do, staying outside, coming in, hit and doesn't get hit. Excellent at slipping punches. There's the lightning left hand. His right hand is just as quick. Causes Norton to miss. Norton trying to cut him off in the corners now. Norton is pretty good moving to his right, but he's not so good moving to his left, which will cause him trouble with the left hand before this fight is over. Lary Holmes' record is unblemished. There he shows he has no fear of Holmes. And Norton shows he has no fear either as he comes in. Getting covered up pretty good in that right hand thrown by Lary. Lary scores the right, good right hand there, taking on the cheek. Lary has great confidence in the eyes, feels he can win. In his own heart and mind knows he can win. He's got better footwork, good right hand, whispers by the to Skinner Norton. No damage done. Okay, a pretty exciting round one, a better round one than we thought we have. An even round one. Now we get a chance to show you Ken Norton. We'll tell you a little bit about him. He's considered a good boxer. He's got a good left jab, which we said he doesn't use enough. Round one was an example of that. Watch the exchange we have coming up while we wait for round number two. Holmes to the left of your screen. Okay, nothing there at all. Nothing there so far. And again, good positioning by Kenny Norton there. No damage done there. Bang! A good shot there. Probably the best shot of the fight. The first real good right hand that Lary Holmes threw. Good left hook that time. So, a confidence building round for Lary Holmes as we look at Kenny Norton. If there was a weakness, I'd say that it would be that Kenny Norton can be hit by uppercuts in close, and he has poor mobility to his left, which leaves him vulnerable for the left hook. Norton takes the first shot in round two off the left hand of Lary Holmes. Freddie Brown in the corner of Lary Holmes, one of the great trainers at Bill Prevent. It's Giacchetti, the man that's out in front all the time. And they have the lawyer, Charles Beziani. In the other corners, Bob Byron, Bill Slayton. Bill Slayton, 1977 Trainer of the Year. Kenny Norton doesn't have the quick movement and ability to slip punches that Lary Holmes has. Holmes is scoring punches at will here in round two. Notice how he stays outside the punching area of Norton. Both of these fellas extremely strong. Lary Holmes, 11 pounds lighter at 209. His reach is an inch shorter, 79 is Holmes, 80 is Kenny Norton. The age difference we mentioned. $1 million goes to Holmes for this one, $2 million for the champion. That's what I told you about the uppercut. Look for that uppercut because Holmes, Norton, the way he leans over. See the way he leans his body, Watch for Larry's hand speed. Good left hook to the side of the head. Best shot of the fight so far. Lary Holmes showing how he can double up with that left hand. See the way Norton bends his body over? He's very vulnerable for an uppercut. And if he continues to do it, Holmes will pick it up and nail him. Lary Holmes looks like he's really taking command. It's only round two. It's early to say, but he scores a good right hand from the head of Ken Norton. Lary Holmes, an excellent fighter. Kenny Norton is as well. But the hand speed, and there's the uppercut. Scores. The hand speed is the story here, as Norton is like looping, hooking shots to the, trying to get to the head of Holmes. So far, he hasn't touched him. Holmes, I think Ken Norton just realized now at the end of round number two, no question that that round goes to Lary Holmes. Round one, very even. We go to the corner now, as you look to the corner there, of Lary Holmes standing. We'll tell you a little bit more about the stronger points of Ken Norton. He has staying power. Remember I told you about the uppercut that Lary Holmes would find it with that way that Norton moves his body over? Watch this shot coming up that we have for you. Didn't catch him really hard. He caught him just a little bit to the side of the ear. But if Norton continues to bend over like that, he's going to get himself in trouble. There's Lary Holmes. The pride of Eastern Pennsylvania. They call him the Eastern Assassin. Why wouldn't they? 27-0. 19 knockouts. Relatively few, but he's an educated fighter with educated hands, educated feet. He's going to pick it up and try to take the man in this round, but Holmes will have no part of it. Round three. The World Heavyweight Championship at stake. As Holmes continues to beat Kenny Norton to the punch, and Willie's hitting. This is the way a young Ali used to score punches. So far, Kenny Norton hasn't scored anything. When I say anything, I'm talking about real heavy blows. Lary Holmes has. Notice how Lary stays just outside the reach, just outside the punching area of Kenny Norton, so he's not hit by that. And when Norton takes those wild left hooks at him, he follows up with a crisp left hand that's a shot right in the face of Ken Norton. Lary Holmes looking great so far. Controlling the fight to this point. A surprise. I didn't think he'd do it this early. Kenny Norton is not getting his punches off first. But Norton is strong. He's a man that could take a guy out with one punch. Lord knows he's done it 32 times. Another good shot. There's the uppercut. Lary Holmes is building confidence now. He had tremendous confidence when I spoke to him yesterday, but no confidence like he's showing in the ring right now. That looping right hand again. Lary just slipped away from it. No damage done by that at all. Holmes has actually got Norton confused. Norton's timing doesn't look sharp to Norton all the time. But he misses a nod, it's keeping Norton away. And Norton's only hope then is a long looping right or left hand, which is not doing a job with a lightning quick torso of Holmes. Watch the quickness of the left hand of Holmes. When he'll have to change his style right at this moment now and start circling to the left, causing the problems for Holmes. Hooks to the body, the betting favorite. Heavy punch, but again that looping right hand, and immediately the right hand of Lary Holmes get in there to tag him. Kenny looking a little bit better right now, but he's not scoring. Lary staying just outside, and when the punches do get in there, he flicks his head to the left and causes Norton to miss. This frustrates the fighter. Norton's a great competitor. He's relentless. He continues to come on. Holmes, one of the great men for punching backpedaling. Very few could do it. Ali, of course, the master at hitting moving backpedaling. Where we are, the pavilion at Caesar's Palace. A more even round. We go to the corner of Lary Holmes. I mentioned he's considered the finest boxer in the heavyweight division with his hand and foot speed, and I think for the first time people around the world know who Lary Holmes is now. His best punch, of course, as you saw, the left jab. He sets up combinations off that left. Now we're over to Kenny Norton's corner again. Kenny does not have that real great authoritative look in his eye that he had when the fight started. I wonder if he's been psyched. I don't know. Ken Norton's a gentleman. He's a competitive athlete. Great high school athlete. He's been a great athlete his entire career. He's determined. He's got everything he wants. It's coming down to a question of ability. And we're going to find round four, scheduled for 15, as all world title fights are. While Norton may look taller, Holmes is actually an inch taller, about a half an inch, or three quarters anyway. Who knows? The weigh-in yesterday, they kept the fighters apart to avoid another confrontation like they had earlier in the week. They don't like each other. There's no doubt about that. Richie Cicchetti, the fellow that handles Lary Holmes, told me he wanted him to stay away early, but he'd allow Norton to take the fight to him, but he wanted Lary to control it. And he's done exactly that. So if you go by the fight plan, a good left hook that time scored by Kenny Norton. Lary's showing getting off three and four punches while Kenny gets out one or two. That takes his toll over the fight. You see what I mean about Lary Holmes setting up with the left hand, the left jab, he'll hook to the body and then he'll drop the right hand. Watch him now. See that lightning left? It comes from the hip, a la Ali. He boxed with Ali a tremendous amount. Norton's gone about some 40 rounds with him. But Lary Holmes has the experience of going over a couple of hundred rounds with Muhammad Ali. Holmes has been known to talk to an opponent occasionally. But it's frustrating for Holmes now. I'd rather for Norton now, because Holmes is staying away from those punches. Kenny's not scoring at all. Kenny's best round was the last round, and at that it was still an even round. Lary Holmes is definitely beating him to the punch. He's scoring more punches. Pushing away a lot of punches with that lightning right hand. You see when Kenny comes in with the left hand, Lary pushes it away. Lary scores it. Oh, good right hand! Spins ahead of Norton. Another shot to the side of the head of Norton. Another one! Kenny goes downstairs with a body on that one. Kenny not visibly shaken. Holmes working to the head of Norton. The speed of the hands and the speed of the legs. But so far, Larry Holmes hasn't used his legs to his advantage, which he's famous for. It's all been his hand speed that's beating Norton to the punch. Larry, for the first time, looking like he's huffing and puffing, takes a light left, and the right hand misses, ducks underneath it. But the alertness is in the eyes of Holmes. See a good shot of Norton, looking for his shot, too. See the head spin quickly, the alertness and the quickness of Holmes. Good combination there to the head. So Richie Giacchetti, again, the manager, handles Holmes, wanting to put combination together. Kenny trying to muscle in. Scores to the body, all right. Good, tough fourth round is complete. So we go to the corner now between round four and five of Kenny Norton. We'll talk a little bit more about him. Some of the things you may or may not know. He was presented the WBC heavyweight belt March 29th based on a 15-round decision over Jimmy Young back in November right here at Caesar's Palace. He's intelligent. He's cool. We talked about his great competitiveness, the fact that he won 10 letters. But right now, let's show you how Larry scores a few punches here. And a measuring, bang, over the left. Not a damaging blow, but those over a period of rounds can take their toll. Sets him up again, bang. Didn't really score with that. Not as solid as I thought it was when we called it originally on the replay. Okay, here we go, round five. Larry Holmes, Phil Pike told me yesterday, he's got plenty of, doesn't particularly respect him as a human being, but has all the respect in the world as a boxer for Larry Holmes. Larry Holmes, of course, challenging the champion, had to respect him, but showing little respect and regard for him in the ring before this thing's over. We're in round five. Neither fighter visibly shaken. Neither fighter visibly hurt. Neither fighter has been cut. Nobody down. My name's Bob Sheridan. Glad that you can be with us for this heavyweight championship fight. Larry Holmes, surprising to some, to the people inside boxing, not surprising at all. Kenny Norton has his hands full, the champion of the world, in the blue trunks facing him. It's all hand speed so far, and it's all been to the... Oh, good right hand from the head of Larry Holmes, but that shows you that Holmes can take a punch, and that was a big question heading into this fight. Can he take a punch? I'd say that was a real good shot that Holmes took then, and does not visibly shake him at all, which will frustrate Kenny Norton when you score punches like that and it doesn't take anything out, then the left comes back. Two, three, four, quick left hands and a right follows up. Larry Holmes comes right back. So that shows you he can take a shot. The only time we could say that Norton didn't take a shot was in Caracas in 74 when Foreman knocked him out. But he's taken plenty of punishment from Ali. Good shots now, that jab. Oh, great, great boxing in here now by both of them. Just exchanging blows. Both of them looking for the up. Great shot by Larry Holmes. The right hand to the side of the head. Holmes scores again. Now they're standing just toe-to-toe in the ring and just wailing away at each other. Left hand taken slightly. Both of them had the same idea at the same time. Let's fly with the right and cross them. Keep moving. Use those legs. But Larry wants to trade punches with him. One thing that I can... There he goes now. Listening to his corner, I was just going to say, this man takes direction. Now he's showing his style. Remember those tassels like that that Muhammad Ali wore the first time he met Joe Frazier after the layoff? I can see them now up in the air when he was sitting on his feet wearing the red trunks that night. Larry Holmes has them on. He's copied everything from out. Larry has great foot, great legs. Educated legs, described by many educated boxing people. Well, coming up to round six.
That's right.
Look to measure him, you tighten up.
People around ringside here saying, I don't believe we're coming up to round six. What a fast fight. All that means is one thing. That's his excitement out there that is keeping their interest.
That's right. That's right. You know, now listen.
So far, and I reiterate, this is unofficial at ringside, I have round one even. I have Larry Holmes winning round two. I have three even. I have Holmes winning round four, and I have five even. Scoring close here. The 10-point must. The three judges do the scoring and not the referee, by the way. We look at Larry Holmes, Kenny Norton. Coming up to round six. People from the Norton camp say that he's been in the best shape of his life. By the boards, the preparation's complete. There is no tomorrow. It's all on the line right now. One of these fellows will not be champion. One will be. The belt is sitting idle with a WBC man right now. One of them will wear it out of here. Kenny Norton to the right. Holmes beating him to the punch inside. Larry Holmes, you can see it in his eyes, his great ring awareness. Great confident look. Like Kenny has more of the concerned, determined, plugger type look in his eyes. Mobility to move. This is what they want Holmes to do. They want him to keep moving, cause problems. See the jab in the face of Norton all the time. This is what the young Ali used to do. And this is why so many people felt that Larry Holmes would take the championship from Ken Norton. Kenny showing his determination as he comes right in, continues to press the fight. Larry Holmes, the in and out round for Larry Holmes. Kenny getting a little puffy underneath the left eye. Holmes' face not visibly any marks. That jab continued in the face of Norton. There it is again and again. Light blows, but scoring. Kenny came in that time. Norton caught him with a good, Holmes caught him with a good body punch downstairs. Now Norton taking some leather to the head. There's that uppercut. Well, Larry Holmes is very well aware that the uppercut is a key punch for him. Good shot thrown by Norton that time. Larry Holmes took a good shot, but he came right back. Larry's got to move a little bit more. Ken knows that he really tagged him. And surprisingly, to a man that has the real ring smarts of Larry Holmes, I'm surprised he's not moving more. His corner, of course, has got to move, Larry, move. Now he's back on his toes, doing what he does best, using his legs, sliding to his left. Larry slides to his right, and this is where Norton is awkward. Norton's style with the left foot in front and dragging his right foot. It's very difficult for him to move to his left. And that's what opens things up. A good, good round for both fighters. Have a replay coming up, I'm sure. Here we go now. That's the causing the puffiness. Good right hand. And that's what I mean about Holmes being able to take a shot. As far as I'm concerned, they said he could take a shot, but he was untested at this point. There's the ice on the eye. As we mentioned to you in the last round, started getting puffy. The ice in the eye of Ken Norton. After the fight, Larry Holmes always says to me, gee, I thought I won a lot more rounds. And Larry, I'm not a judge. I'm an announcer. I do the best I can scoring. Stake the World Heavyweight Championship. Kenny Norton holding the title, but it's on the line right now. Instructions of Larry Holmes to move more, and the instructions of Kenny Norton would be to try and cut him off in the corners. There's the jab in the face of Norton. Kenny doesn't have the mobility both ways that Larry Holmes has, but Larry hasn't been using it a tremendous amount in this fight. Larry's fighting more flat-footed than I've seen him fight before. And I'm sure his corner would like to see him using one. Now there's some good movement there. A lot of people came out from Eastern Pennsylvania to see Holmes, and a lot of people came over from California to Las Vegas to see Kenny Norton, the heavyweight champion. Kenny tries to work downstairs, and immediately the challenger, Holmes, ties him up. That's Holmes to the left of your screen. And coming into the screen now, facing you, is Kenny Norton to the left now. There's the foot movement that the corner of Holmes wants him to use. To come in and out. Angelo Dundee, the great trainer, says, I'd like to see a guy that has that leg speed come in and out. Punch going away. Very few people could do it. Certainly Gene Tunney against Dempsey in that famous long pound fight in Chicago made that famous. And then along came Ali. who patented his punches, watching cause Norton in his punches now, which is frustrating. When you're as big and strong and such exceptional athletes. This is what Lary should be doing. Norton comes in and scores with a head, though. Lary spins him around, showing his strength. Norton, for the first time, gave that glare back at him. Like, you're not controlling me, friend. A little more concern showing the face now of Holmes. Good left hook catches him. I watch Lary pick it up now here. When he's hitting, he usually tries to pick it up immediately to get that right back. Norton's hands are very busy. Takes a lot of leather. Good combination that time by Kenny Norton. The bell sounds, ending the round number 7. Well, working on the left eye of Kenny Norton, which could become a factor later on down the line. Lary Holmes, of course, earned the shot at this man with a decision which really put him in the high ranking and gained worldwide recognition when he completely control the fight against Ernie Shavers back in March. Holy so Norton, here we go. Let's see if the pace changes or anything. Good right hand, good combination score. Holmes has come on here in round 8. He's got that look back in his eyes now, the look of determination. He's got the concern look back in the eyes of Norton. Best series of punches thrown by Lary. Richard Giacchetti again told me he wanted Lary to go game. He's such a great competitor. It's not easy to control him. Scores good inside. Guys do not like each other, and I think it's obvious by some of the stares you can see. Norton not quite the disciplined player. The arms flail a little bit more. Holmes has total body control inside all the time. Kenny's more apt to have that looping left and the looping right hand. And the quickness of the hands of Holmes shows inside. There's that looping hand, and then again the quickness inside. Everybody was yelling, oh yeah, like Norton did something there, but it was actually Holmes that beat him inside. The looping hand and arm. Now that was a good punch that time, thrown by Norton. Kenny Norton to the left. That shot scored too. Going by Ken again. So Lary gets on the bicycle now. There's Lary using his wares to his best advantage now, moving around. Wild is Kenny with the left, but scores a series of lefts there. Wild was he with the right again. Norton is forcing this fight much more than I thought he would. He's been aggressive continually throughout the fight. That's how he was able to beat Jimmy Young here on aggressiveness. Norton looking for the opportunity to measure his man, but Holmes not giving him that opportunity as he continues to bounce away. This is one of the better rounds for Ken Norton, by the way. Holmes came out flailing in the first round. Good left hand to the face. Good left hand. Oh, good combination by the champion. Good combination. Good uppercut that time by Holmes. Kenny really wants him. He can taste it. He's going after him so hard. Lary Holmes says, take that if you want to taste some of that. All right. The referee, Mills Lane, has to separate them. The people like this one. I told you going into it, it would be one of the best, and it has been. That round has a go to Kenny Norton.
Stop the lag.
So reiterate a bit back here as we go down the line. I had round 1 even. I had Holmes winning 2. I had 3 even. I had 4 to Holmes. 5, 6, and 7 all even. And Kenny Norton, I gave him that one on the basis that he did score some pretty heavy blows during round number 8. Back in the 6th round, Norton a little puffy on that eye that they're working on right now. Again in his corner, Bill Slayton, Bob Byron, those are the people. Slayton, of course, the 1977 Manager of the Year.
You're the champ. You're the champ.
go over to Richie Giacchetti working on Larry Holmes. Holmes a real determined look on his face. The only thing that can stop the quicker hands of Larry Holmes is if a few of those heavy blows of Norton begin to land. We're in round nine. This is scheduled for 15. Good shot by Norton that time. But again, the head of Holmes is... Oh, another good right hand then. Holmes can take a shot. He's shown me something here. He can take a shot. Larry has been better with his combinations and that left jab in the face of Norton, but the heavier blows, I think, have been landed by Kenny Norton. Although it's hard to tell exactly how heavy because the way Holmes moves his head so quickly. That's the one thing you miss when you watch it on television. You can't tell the heaviness of the punches. But I'll tell you right now, these jabs are light. And I'll tell you when they get heavier by either man. That was a heavy jab. In fact, that was more than just a heavy jab. That was a punch. Larry Holmes now has that look back in his eye of the determination, like he's looking for a shot to unload the right hand. And by the fact that he's circling to his left, I'll tell you, it's coming very shortly. But Norton doesn't allow him to get it off. To the credit of Kenny Norton, the champion of the world. Holmes will circle left and try to get Norton leaning that way, then drop the right hand. That shows you the Ali type of style of Holmes there, the way he walked away from that. Jimmy Ellis was famous for that as well, wild with the left. Holmes circling to his left, looking to hook to the left with his left and drop the right hand. Norton wild with the right again. Kenny Norton, heavyweight champion of the world, and wants to keep it. Lord knows he's waited long enough for a title. Ah, good shot that time by Larry Holmes. He's circling back to his right now. Oh, real good right hand scored by Kenny. Good shot. I tell you, Holmes can really take a shot because that was a good one. No bounce taken out of the legs of Holmes at all. Another good shot by Kenny Norton. Now Holmes wants to pick up the pace so this round doesn't get out of his hands. He's got to score a few more punches to keep. There's a good shot by Holmes. Scores downstairs. That one missing. Kenny has scored two real good shots in this round. There's the bell ending the round. Which means at this point in the fight, I have it scored dead even. Coming up by Kenny Norton. Watch him now. Keep an eye on this. Bang! What a shot that was. Many a fighter would have been off his feet with that one. Still working on the corner now and in the left eye there of Kenny Norton. That right hand would have flattened many fellas. That answers the big question I mentioned a couple of times, and I'll reiterate again that Larry Holmes can take a whale of a shot. If Holmes is going to win, it'll be a accumulation of combinations and punches. Preferably from Holmes' viewpoint to that left eye. Try and shut it, then work to the other one. Holmes knows he's got to get something cooking here now because the fight is at a point where it could take a turn there. Kenny's scoring more shots to the face now. That one did not score, by the way. Larry showing a little bit more respect. Now, this also is a point where Norton scores there again. Larry gets on his bicycle. We're getting into the 10th round now, a territory that Larry Holmes doesn't know. 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, doesn't know, hasn't been there. Kenny Norton's been there many times. His tremendous staying power. Although the people that handle Larry Holmes tell me he's got all the strength he needs to go 15. He's had some 200 rounds of boxing in preparation. Larry's not throwing too many punches right now. Kenny seems to have scored a couple here in this round. Now I see that a little more concerned look at the face of Holmes. The determined, relentless look on the face of Norton. He just scored there a pretty good right hand. Larry's got to get a little more offensive-minded now. Norton looking real strong here. Norton's jab that looked crisp that time. There's the great quickness in the head of Larry Holmes. The two jabs out there by Norton And again, Norton has good hand speed, but it doesn't look as great because Holmes has exceptional hand speed. It's a right hand. That's what I mean about exceptional hand speed. That one just snuck in there, spun the head. Norton can take a shot, too. The only time that he couldn't was against the wild right hand of George Foreman in Caracas. And a few heads of cattle that couldn't take a shot like that. This was amazing. And Kenny Norton, that staked the heavyweight championship of the world. Maneuver here. Round 10. And he scores with that left hand. He's just trying to save a little bit of energy and let Holmes, let Norton kind of smoke himself out a bit. They give that round again to Kenny Norton. So now with, and again I reiterate that this is only unofficial scoring by me. I have the last three rounds in favor of Ken Norton, which puts him slightly out in front in the fight. Well, my scoring is anywhere as near accurate, but again, the vantage point of the judges who are doing all the scoring, not the referee, but the judges do the scoring here, can give a different viewpoint. So if you win in a couple of points of each other at any time, it doesn't mean a heck of a lot. A couple of times. Shavers, you win 12. See if Norton tries to really maintain what he started to do back in round 8 and continue through 9 and 10, or if Holmes was trying to coast a little bit and will come back and take command. An interesting point in the fight now. Vicious battle with Jimmy Young over the distance. Holmes is not as aggressive as he was early in the fight. He's backpedaling, hitting while he's going away. If he wants to regain the command that I thought he had early in the fight, he's going to have to start scoring some more punches. That's what he likes to do, make Norton look awkward, catch him off balance, and try to drop him. Again, neither fighter has been cut, neither fighter has been down. We're in round 11. The heavyweight championship of the world at stake. People now are suddenly yelling for Norton. One thing the fans like is the aggressiveness. Ken has not taken too many steps back. He's been constantly after Holmes all the time. Holmes bouncing around, scores the lightning lift. Now they're yelling for Lary. They're yelling that, like the Ali chant, it's the Lary, Lary that you hear, which gives him a little extra psych and gets his something pumped up there anyway. You see that enthusiasm back in his face as he feels the crowd sway to his side. It's probably a split crowd. Norton so close. And, of course, people living so close, I should say, from San Diego, California, living in L.A., a lot of people over here to see him win. And, of course, Holmes is a big crowd out from eastern Pennsylvania. He's the underdog, and people like the dog. That looked a lot better than it really was. But Lary has got to get more aggressive. Norton is scoring the punches. Lary is fighting defensively now. Earlier we had a big upset for the same reason. Jimmy Young lost to Jaws Ocasio because he wasn't aggressive. Lary running to his right now, which makes Norton go to his left. People don't like that, but Larry's going to use what he has. Shouldn't allow himself to get on the ropes. Norton's too strong for this sort of thing. And that's why. Took a good shot that time. Holmes scoring more punches again in round. Norton scoring more. Oh, we'll be approaching the 12th round now. We go back to, well, now we're over to the corner of Holmes, and I'm sure Giacchetti is telling him, and he began to take command. I wasn't quite sure how to score the 8th round, to be honest with you. And certainly in the 9th, 10th, and 11th, Norton has definitely landed more punches as Larry's gone strictly defensive. You hear them yelling, Norton, Norton, Norton now. It's a split crowd here. No matter who wins, they're all going to be for the champion when the bell sounds in round 15, unless there's a surprising knockout here.
You're going all right. This is the 11th to 12th.
Now let's see if he takes the direction of Richie Giacchetti. Does Lary Holmes? Norton doesn't want to let Holmes have the pace back of the fight. He's kind of taking control the last couple of rounds. Kenny's headhunting. Strong. Awfully strong. Now Larry's keeping him off again, but that time Norton scores again. Norton continues to force the fight, which is not good for Lary Holmes. But it's Larry's style. By this time, Lary should be trying to maintain a little bit more control of the fight, which he's not doing at this particular moment. Lary just ducked away from that wild round. Nothing punishing, though. See the look of concern in the face of Lary Holmes now? We didn't see that in the early rounds. Realizing he's struggling a bit. Norton's punches look awfully strong, awfully powerful. Lary showing his quickness again. Holmes to the right, Norton to the left. Norton continued the aggressive, scoring to the head of Holmes. Thing we expected to see Lary do a little bit more is double up more. He's not doubling with the left hand and he's not throwing his right hardly at all. Left eye of Kenny Norton is really swollen now. Lary Holmes looks like he might be slightly arm weary now. The punches are not quite as crisp as they were before. And Norton is looking stronger all the time. Left hook has looked better in this fight than I've seen him against a lot of fellas. Timing of Larry's slightly off now in comparison to the early rounds. Both fighters. There's a good shot. Lary Holmes has got to try and pick up the pace a little bit more. He's trying a little bit more even than the rest, but the aggressiveness of Norton scoring again. Well, the bell ends round 12 for the first time we see fatigue set into both fighters. A fairly even round. Score that one even. Look to the corner once again of Kenny Norton. There's 128-126. Unofficially out in front is Ken Norton. We have three rounds to go, which means that Lary Holmes must win two out of three to have any shot. And he must win the last round convincingly if he's to take this title away from Ken Norton. Norton's been involved in close decisions. Close decisions he's won against Jimmy Young. Close decisions he's lost against Muhammad Ali. He's been victimized one way and gifted another way. Lary Holmes is undefeated. That's on the line. He said he should stay away early. That was their fight. See if he can or if Norton will continue the aggressive. Holmes has a good look back in his eye now. The respite in between rounds there did him some good. I can see that alert look in his eye again. But he's got to be aggressive. He's not starting out that way in this round. The better combinations in the fight have been scored by Holmes. The heavier punches, the outstanding punches have been scored by Norton. Fight very even. I have Kenny Norton slightly out in front, ever so slightly. And now Holmes is looking better in this round, and he's got to. He's got to take a little bit more command, though. He's counterpunching too much. He's got to come after him a bit more. Kenny hasn't scored anything in this round at all. Lary scored some short jabs keeping him off, which he's got to do, but he's got to use that right hand and double up with the left. Norton Wiley, and there's a cute right hand in there, sneaky right hand. There's a good shot now. The fatigue is causing Larry's timing to be just ever so slightly off, but he's still scoring more punches now. This is what he's got to do. Keep Norton off of the left and pick his shots. Use the right hand more. Now it looks like a better Lary Holmes. All right, another good shot by Lary Holmes. Real good shot by Holmes that time. Spins ahead of Norton. Now Larry's taking the fight back to him. Although he backs up. Backing up doesn't mean anything because he is one of the very few heavyweights in history that can hit going away. Good run. shaping up for Lary. Good right hand again. Maybe those breathing rounds are what he needed to keep himself going for the late rounds to save himself a bit. Scoring now, real good punches. While Norton did lace out there with a couple of lefts, there was nothing behind them. Holmes's punches look much heavier in round 13 here. Another good shot. Lary is really scoring the heaviest shots now in round 13. Kenny missing. Larry's got to stay off of those ropes. Use his legs a little bit more. The knees of Norton look a little bit jellied like now. Another good shot there. His right hands are taking the toll of Norton. He's got him staggered, I believe. He's got him scoring good combinations. The right hand is taking its toll on Norton. Lary hits him again. Big round for Lary Holmes. Both fellas slightly arm weary, but Holmes is really labeling Norton in this round. Lary taking the vision away with the left hand and then dropping the right in. With the right. He's got Norton wobbly again, taking another shot. He scored at least 10 good right hands. Big round for Lary Holmes. Big round.
And he needed it.
And you can see when that water comes from the corner, they know it. I'm scoring that round 10-8 because more heavy punches were scored than any other round. At least 10 by Lary Holmes. I have the fight dead even right now. Watch the heaviness of the shot. Watch the head. Not there. Keep your eye peeled. Not yet. You'll see it when it comes. Bang. No big deal there either. Hang on now. Now suddenly the crowd is yelling live here, Lary. But let's watch this. Well, it's quite dead even right now. We're in round 14. 15-round championship fight. Neither fighter has been down. Norton slightly wobbly in the 13th round. Norton had been taken complete command from the 8th to the 11th. Ball was even. Holmes must continue because the fight is very close. Again, that scoring that I have even is unofficial. The judges do the scoring here. I have nothing to do with it. Makes Norton look awkward, does Holmes, which is frustrating. Lary has a real alert look back in his face, even though Norton looks to be really much more aggressive now. Punches don't seem to have the steam that they had earlier. His fatigue has caused him to be awkward. Lary Holmes is going to pick up the pace a bit, though. I always look at a fighter's eyes, and you can almost tell how he's feeling right now. Norton's eyes, he looks like he's really wobbly now. Timing is gone. Not completely, because Lary Holmes is fatigued as well, but not as bad. Lary beats him to the punch, counter-punching there. Pushes him off the ropes. You can see Norton's legs are rubbery, his knees. He has very little bounce left in his knees. He's almost, I won't say staggering, but his legs are definitely, I don't even want to say the word gone, but his legs are showing more fatigue than Holmes, I'll put it that way. Good right hand stroke by Norton, but it had no effect at all on Holmes. A lot of parring inside and nothing to any avail or any advantage of either fighter on this inside stuff. Holmes has got to step back and take longer shots now. Holmes looks to be more fresh to me right now. But Norton has the heart of a champ coming in all the time. Lary just stepped back and I almost have to take a sigh with him to catch your breath. Exchanged right hands that time. There's Lary on the move. This is what he should continue to do. Scores with an uppercut and scores again. Kenny Norton doesn't back up though. Continues to pour on. He knows how important it is to be aggressive. Scores a good shot to the head of Lary Holmes. Lary Holmes taking some shots here now. Good round for Kenny Norton. Larry's got to get out of that corner. Kenny's starting to score some punches here. Kenny trying to take command of this round. Lary does not want him to do it, needless to say. Well, in. It's a very difficult round to score, but almost have to give it to Kenny Norton. And throughout the round, Holmes looked fresher to me, but Norton scored more punches. Lary fought defensively. I have it scored unofficially again to recap, because we're heading to the 15th round. I had the first round even. I had round two for Holmes, three even, four for Holmes, five, six, and seven even. Then Norton took command in the eighth round for four rounds, eight, nine, 10, 11. I had 12 even. 13 was a very, very strong round for Lary Holmes, but he did not continue it. Slightly by the fact that he was more aggressive in the 14th round, I gave it to Norton. Again, my scoring is unofficially, and again, it's only 1 point apart going to 15. This should be one whale of a finish. All the marbles on the line, and millions of dollars to boot is on the line right now. Very important for both men to win round 15. This is when you find out who is the heart and who is the champion right now. Norton continues to be the aggressor. Lary should not allow this. Come on, they're both fighting for their lives. Good shots by Holmes, Ford. And he just missing that one. Norton scores a looping right hand that time. Lary cannot let it continue like this, or he's going to lose the fight. It's that close, in my opinion. Lary has that alert look back, like he's just waiting for about halfway through the round, and then he's going to explode. Let Norton punch himself out in the early going. And that's what Kenny is scoring a bit, though. That bounces the head back of Lary Holmes. Lary misses. Both fighters very, very tired. First time that Holmes has gone this far. Lary has got to explode here if he's going to win this fight. He's got to just get a second win and explode. And the way he's doing it now, Norton's taking command of the 15th round. At least halfway through now, round 15. If it continues like this, it's in the hands of the judges. It's too close for me to score. Unless Holmes explodes here. Kenny Norton taking it to Lary. Lary is fighting back really now. This is what he has to do. See if he's got enough left to take the champ out. Scores with the right hand. The champ comes back. Comes back and scores a real good shot to the head of Holmes. Another good shot. Takes the mouthpiece out of the mouth of Lary Holmes. Kenny Norton doing what he has to do to win. Scoring again. It's a big round for Kenny Norton, I'm afraid. In the waning moments now of the round, Lary is fighting desperately to stay in there, fighting with everything he has. Scores good with a shot to the head of Kenny Norton. Again to the head of Norton. This has been a great boxing show. Both fighters courageous. As Holmes comes back, scores a good shot. He's got Norton in trouble. Yes. He's got a follow-up. Uppercut scores. Running out of time, and that's it. It's all over. Well, Holmes put on a last-second flurry. It's going to be very, very close. Too close for me to call. Could be a split decision. We don't know. Unofficially, I personally think Norton won the last round. Give him the fight. We'll switch over to our handheld mic and go into the ring now.
I tell you what, he did that like a pro, man. Norton won it.
Obviously, Holmes people think he has won the fight. With me is Jose Suleiman. Jose, could you venture to guess who's won this fight?
No, but I'm very proud of all of him. What fight? I mean, the best fight that I have seen in many, many years.
Jose, I've broadcast over 50 championship fights, and I can't recall a better fight showing the heart. Either one of these guys could be champion in my book.
I believe exactly the same thing. This is one of the greatest fighters I have ever seen in my life.
That's Jose Suleiman, the president of the World Boxing Council. We will attempt to speak with both fighters. Obviously, the corner of Holmes and the people on Holmes' side feel he has won the title. Kenny Norton finished very strong. Too close for me to call.
Scores 143-142, Holmes.
One judge, 143-142, Holmes. 1 point separating the fighters with that judge.
Scores 143-142, Norton.
143-142, Norton. It all depends on the final judge.
No way.
Scores it. 143-142 for the new
Lary Holmes has done it.